Something else I want to mention is that there are many different version control systems, but we can classify them normally in two main types: centralized VCSs and decentralized VCSs. So what is the difference between these two? Let's use again our friends Janet and Brad. In the case of a centralized version control system, there is a single centralized, as the name says, repository on which they're committing their files. So when Janet commits a file, the file will go from her local working directory to the repository, and the same will happen to Brad. The decentralized system is a little more interesting because in this case, they will both have sort of a local repository in which they can commit their changes. So they can commit changes without the other users of the VCS being able to see these changes. And when they're happy with the version, or when they're ready to release the version, they can push it to a central repository. And at that point, it will become available to the other users of the repository, to the other users of the VCS. There are several advantages in a distributed system. I'm just going to mention a few because there are really many. One is the fact of having this local version. If you use VCS before, I'm sure you've been in the situation in which you want to kind of take a snapshot of what you have, but you don't want that snapshot to be available to the other users because it's still not ready to be released, to be looked at. If you're using a centralized system, there's really no way you can do that unless you make a local copy, which is something we said you don't want to do. With a distributed, with a decentralized VCS, you can commit your local changes here in your local repository, and you can push them to the central repository only when you're ready. Another big advantage is that you can use multiple remote repositories. And in fact, centralized is not the right name for this one. This is just a remote repository, and I can have more than one. For example, Brad might want to push to another remote repository as well. For instance, this could be a repository where the files are accessible for wider distribution. Imagine developing a software system in which a team is sharing internal versions, and then only some of these versions are actually pushed to the repository that is seeable to the whole world.